Hey guys, MBG here with a look at the latest White Dwarf. This is issue 49, dated 3rd of January 2015, and pretty much is jam-packed with the newest kit for Games Workshop, the Vermin Lord. Of course, this thing is well, there's a lot of rumors out about it. I mean, we've seen a lot during this week, and there's a ton of different versions of it, and it looks really awesome. It's apparently as big as Nagash, and in game it's a powerhouse depending on which version you take. So it's always nice to see new stuff coming out, especially for fantasy, and something that you can always has tons of conversion capability and possibilities as far as the things you could make for 40K or even fantasy, or even convert it up using all the other crazy existing Skaven kits out there. And so we'll kind of touch on that some when we take a look at the actual versions of the Vermin Lord itself. So as far as content goes, we've got the big feature on the Skaven Vermin Lord here, some Black Library stuff, the new Blood Angel box set as well. Then we've got some Forge World, and it looks like they actually kind of caught up with Forge World. Like, they're pretty close as far as stuff that came out a couple weeks ago is now in here. They don't ever seem to be quite in sync. Maybe it's on purpose, maybe not, but still it's cool to see stuff actually in print from Forge World, because a lot of it's just digital. Then it gets into some other Skaven stuff here. We got the rules, some basically backgrounds and things like that, like on each one of the different Vermin Lords. Then there's a paint splatter article, which is very, very good for painting Skaven. All the different parts, like the horns, the flesh, the clothes, the metals, all sorts of stuff. It's a really good article. Some people might pick it up just for that, because I mean it's a lot of really good instruction as far as painting a whole bunch of different ranges and individual components out there that you'll definitely encounter. And there's some stuff in the back, like new features and things like that. Nothing we really ever heavily get into. But let's go ahead and hit these Vermin Lords here, right? So the first version is called the Warpseer. Now, it doesn't look like it belongs to a particular clan, at least it doesn't say so. And of course, notice Nagash up there. Now, it looks like they're about right next to each other, and Nagash is looking kind of skinny. You need to put on some weight, girl. The Vermin Lord here is ginormous. Now, this one, of course, is the caster, because you can kind of see some of his artifacts and things here, and it gets into it in the article. It doesn't attribute it to a particular clan, even though, I guess as far as clans and magic goes, that would kind of be the Greyseer's realm, and I don't think there is a specific clan for the Greyseers themselves. This guy, however, has his own clan. This is the Vermin Lord Deceiver, and he belongs to the Eshin clan, which is, all the badass assassins that do all their ninja flips and throw their stars and appear out of nowhere to take out your enemy general, or at least attempt to, right? So they was always fun to play against. It's got a really cool kind of General Grievous mask right here. I definitely feeling some General Grievous action right there. And then, of course, the crazy Skaven ninja star thing that we've seen on a few assassin models to date. And then, of course, it's kind of got that cool pose, some crazy tail action here. I mean, that thing's I don't even know. I hope that's plastic, right? I'm sure it is, but it's definitely something that you could have never done in the past if these things weren't plastic. Then we get into the Corruptor guy here, and he's pretty cool looking. He's got some size, kind of got that wood elf kind of feel to him, as far as that goes. Part of Clan Pestilence, which of course is the guys, the quote unquote Nurgle guys, the plague monks, the guys that make all those crazy like bombs and poison attack things, and they're just really cool. I mean, they've always had really great models, and it's kind of cool to see them get their own little Vermin Lord guy. Then there's the Warbringer, which doesn't specifically get into a specific clan here, but to me it kind of seems like he's one of the Moor clan, because the Moor clan, because they were like the I guess the war, they were the Warbringers. They were the guys, they were the dedicated warrior class, I guess, for lack of a better term, as far as the Skaven goes. So it doesn't exactly get into that, but that's kind of how I'm feeling about it. Now, again, really cool looking stuff. Of course, he's got the armor because he's the warrior. Some crazy, crazy weaponry here. I don't even know what that is, but it looks pretty dope, and a nice crazy horns there. Definitely something you don't want to mess with on the battlefield, right? And I'm sure his profile definitely reflects it. Then there's the Vermin King, which It's kind of hard to explain like exactly what role he is there to fill. Now, he gets some specific spells as far as rules go, but supposedly, as far as the lore is, he was an amalgam of the first Council of 13 that, well, not, I guess not the first one, but the one that defeated Nagash originally, or had a big hand in it, like the infiltration and the telling, ordering what exactly to happen to ultimately lead to Nagash's first downfall. So I'm sure Nagash and this guy are going to have a bone to pick, so to speak, in some upcoming battles, which hopefully we see a new End Times book, which we'll get to the spoilers here in a second. So more previews, lots of cool stuff, some fluff on the Skaven themselves, and then we get to the rules section, which I'm sure is what a lot of people are wondering about. Now, granted, if you buy the model next week, I'm sure it comes with the insert that shows you all the rules. But maybe don't have that. Maybe you have some models you want to use to represent the Skaven Lord. Maybe or the Vermin Lords. Maybe you want to play test with it right now. And that's what's up. So let's take a look at some of the rules here. Now, here's the Deceiver. Again, he was the Ashen, the assassin kind of looking dude. There's all of his stuff here. So he's got some pretty interesting attacks. Oh, and of course, there is the normal. Basically, special rules, like as far as the stuff, like the guy, the 8-inch movement, some of them have specific rules. Like I said, the Vermin King always knows the dreaded 13, which is pretty neat, because that's sometimes you want to plan your moves and things around that. It's a very big for Skaven players. If you ever played against them, or you've played Skaven yourself, you know exactly what I'm talking about. It can get a little dicey. I personally miss what was it, Curse of Ears. Oh no, I think that was Vampire Counts. Ah, it all blends together for me sometimes, but I definitely didn't like that spell. Whoever cast it, I didn't like it. Oh my goodness. Anyway, so back to this, then we've got the different versions here. You got the Warbringer, the Corruptor, Warp Seers, and the Vermin King, of course. Each in kind of doing their own thing. They average anywhere from 500 to 650 points, depending on their actual role and what they do. Of course, Vermin King seems to be the most expensive as far as that goes. Now, he's got the Plague Reaper. That's pretty cool. Those crazy looking things there. So, I mean, pretty cool stuff. Definitely check it out, because these guys definitely look like they'll be a fixture on the tabletop as far as Fantasy Battle goes for a long time. Here's the Paint Splatter article, and like I said, it's a really good article because it covers so many broad topics. I mean, you've got flesh and fur, face, skull, snout and skull, which snouts are actually kind of hard to do if you think about it. Beards, I don't even know what that word is because it's too far away. Horns. And then you get into some of the weapons, warp stones, armors, and this is a pretty cool like alternate armor scheme here. This is kind of like a, I guess I would say not exactly non-metallic metal, but more like a dark Mechanicus kind of feel to it, which is definitely something you could use with all those Mechanicus rumors out there. I'll just throw it out there right now. If Adeptus Mechanicus is released, totally painting them all Dark Mechanicus, because that's so awesome, and they'll go perfect with my Iron Warriors. Then we get to some more organic stuff here, as far as in runes as well, and then eyes. I mean, that's a pretty cool little paint scheme there, as far as the crazy looking eye goes. So good stuff. Like I said, this article right here might just be worth the purchase price of the White Dwarf and picking it up. But then having the rules and everything is definitely a huge bonus, because I mean, like I said, getting them a little early, having them to play test things like that. Spoiler alert, here we go. So on sale next week, we got the Skaven Attack. Could be, End Times Preview Book 4, supposedly named Thankful, who knows? Mephiston versus the Swarm Lord, Round 2, which was a pretty cool little battle report from a few issues ago. And then the End Times, a timeline. So that would be kind of neat to see, because a lot of the stuff is occurring almost simultaneously and overlapping, and things that happen, for instance, in Sylvania, have a far-reaching influence on other parts of the Empire, and maybe even now that all the elves have fled and are in a particular part of the Old World, now we start seeing how maybe the Skaven are going to rise up and go into Britonia. And a lot happened in Britonia, so definitely a timeline might be in order, because there's a lot going on there, and trying to piece it all together of what happened when and who's where, and Nagash went here and then went here, and it's just a lot to keep track of. So that'll be pretty neat to see. I'm definitely looking forward to that one. So that's pretty much it for this one, and then a cool little feature on the back there just to kind of show you exactly how big that new Vermin Lord model is, at least as big as the Mortarks. If not quite as big as Nagash, we don't really know if that was the intent or if it was just like, hey, let's kind of put him in the background and he's not really that big. But I mean, I imagine for a similar price point, he probably is, you know what I mean? So, like I said, that's pretty much it for this one. Make sure you stay in the trenches. Check out our blog, spikybitsblog.com. You subscribe to this YouTube channel right now. All you got to do is click up in the right-hand corner. And also, listen to our podcast, ForgeNarrative.com.